Je kent het vast wel. Thuis lekker op de bank als student de hoorcolleges online volgen. Of dat je met verschillende collega's tegelijk vanuit verschillende landen in een online videomeeting zit. Tegenwoordig is dat dankzij online videoplatformen mogelijk. Maar wanneer zijn deze online platformen eigenlijk ontstaan? En wat kun je er allemaal mee? Jaron Vietor van DDV Tech kan ons daar meer over vertellen.
The internet has always been about communication. In the beginning there was simply not enough bandwidth to do anything besides text. In 1991 the first live webcam went online, which was only one frame every 20 seconds. Then around the year 2000, live radio became a thing because now consumer connections are fast enough to handle a constant audio stream. Only a few years later, video became possible, and it is now the norm to watch your TV over the internet instead of through a separate cable. Besides watching TV online, there are many other examples. A well-known example is YouTube. Relatively new are the streaming platforms, where users contribute content of something that they're doing, and other users watch this in real time. In the corporate world, conference calls are a well-known example. Also, a lot of religious instances will be broadcasting their services online. Relatively new is the trend to build your own platform instead of making use of an existing platform, usually because of limitations of the existing platform. At the core of every live video platform is the so-called streaming server. This is a piece of software that makes sure that the right data arrives at the right timing, in the right format, at the right people. You also need to make sure that you keep track of encoding, which means converting the raw signal to a format suitable for live distribution. For both of these, there are open source solutions. Open source is a type of software where volunteers program the software and you can use it free of charge. Of course, you'll often want to make modifications or have special requests, and then there are professional solutions you can use. When building a live video platform, it's important that you pick something that has the flexibility, both for what you currently want from it and what you might want in the future. The world of online video is constantly changing. Because of this, it's critical that you pick a solution that will offer the help and support that you need to build the unique features that you want for your platform. The basics of any video platform are effectively the same. Because of this, it is critical that you pay attention to what makes your platform unique. By using a core component that does all the basics for you correctly, you can focus on that uniqueness in your platform and make sure that you build the features and the functionality that you need to make your platform unique. By reusing a core component, you can cut down on personnel costs because your platform will be easier to maintain. In addition, using video technology will allow you to enable remote work so that you can cut down on travel costs and increase your sustainability.